biofuels offer the country the prospect of long-term sustainability so that we could have supply of biofuels long after our fossil fuels become more difficult to get, more expensive. The Agrobot is a small track robot. It can walk through an agricultural field, measuring each plant as it goes along, so it'll measure the stem diameter, the height of the plant, the leaf area of the plant, and we're modifying sensors so that we can also measure photosynthesis. We can now determine the complete DNA sequence of this plant. You could do that perhaps with an army of people, but what the robot can do is do all of that for you. So you can now combine how the plant's performing with the genetic blueprint, and then we can start to pick out genes which underlie good performance and say, this is the combination of genes we need to get the best plant.
Currently, we're evaluating it on sorghum. Sorghum's pretty similar to wheat and corn in terms of the way it grows and looks. The variety of sorghum that we're breeding for this project, it's pretty amazing. It grows 12 foot tall, and it's actually energy sorghum. This is the sorghum whose biomass is converted for ethanol or for other ways of creating energy. If we can make a robot work in a sorghum field, we're pretty confident that it'll work in a wheat field or a corn field. Pretty much as the robot is moving around, it's transmitting data, and the breeder can continuously monitor the type of data that the robot is sending back. Of course, the robot also stores the data, so the breeder can collect all of the data from all of the plots at the end of the day.
And by being able to describe many thousands of plants, this is going to hugely accelerate our improvement of crops around the world. I'd like to see we can hand something off to my grandchildren and their generation, that they have a sustainable, indefinite supply of fuel within the country for the future, that we no longer need to worry about supplies of fossil fuels from outside of the country.